So before he starts putting it, I'll just say a few words about laser DCR. Again, not many people are still in favor of it, but I can assure you, if you learn it properly and you have a good teamwork, it's not a procedure which cannot be learned. And you need to, you know, see the videos on the YouTube, learn the nasal endoscopy yourself. I have not been taught anything by anyone regarding the laser DCR. I've learned it on my own. So I can assure you, you can also do it. Just a little patience and perseverance and you can learn anything. And I'll just go to the, you know, surgical part, it's per se, because I don't think there's much time left. Only thing is that various lasers have been used, and diode itself, you know, the 810 has also been described, but we have just published 980 nanometer gives the better profile. And most important thing is, when you have your patients, you must go give have a good vasoconstriction. That is, you must start prescribing xylometazoline drops at least a week before you do the surgery, because one thing, external DCR, bleeding occurs, you can get away with it, but if while doing an endoscopy, your, you know, bleeding starts, you have to abandon, or you really have to go on packing in between. So be very careful about this, and before you start the surgery, a good packing is a must. I need to reiterate that. Now, you just need to know the anatomy. You already understood, hey, this is the endoscopic view, this is the middle turbinate, and this is at the root of the middle turbinate that we are going to create this opening. It's at the root of it. So you need to identify, this is the middle turbinate, and it is here that you need to create the opening. So again, reiterating, please go back, see your nasal, these videos, and you will know it. This is the middle turbinate which is showing. And this opening, initially the laser DCR, the failure rates were high because they used to make the opening just with the laser, and it used to be small in size, say about 4, 5, 6 millimeter. What I started doing is that initial opening is created with the laser, and subsequently I make it, I enlarge it with the instruments. So this is, I have a no financial interest. This is Appa Swami, the cheapest machine available for laser DCR which I have. And the wattage which I use is about 8 watts, a continuous mode. And this is the middle turbinate which you can see here. And right here is the area where you need to target. And this is after you, you know, you just confirm it's an NLD block, you pass your probe through the canaliculus, and once it hits the bone, you know that you're at the right place, you start firing, and endoscopically you keep viewing that your beam should always be, you know, brightly seen. If it's diffuse beam, that means you are at the wrong place. This opening is gradually enlarged by, you know, the probe keeps hitting the bone, you just withdraw it. Once you again feel the soft tissue, again you take it to a place where you can feel the bone. It's a contact laser. So under direct visualization, you keep firing and you create an opening about 4 into 4 millimeter. How do you know it's 4 millimeter? It's because the suction catheter which you're using, it's about 2 millimeter in size. So twice the, you know, size of that suction catheter would be 4 millimeter. That's a very simple procedure of assessing your osteotomy size also. After, and this is the red-free light being on. Sometimes, you know, you're not able to see the beam, so you just put off the light and you can see the red light from here. So this is the probe which is coming, and these charged pieces, they can be removed with a Blakesley's forceps. Please go to your ENT department, just see what a Blakesley's forceps is, what a sickle knife is, and you can easily pick up this procedure, not at all difficult. Now, various adjuncts have been used, the silicone stents and all. We had a study and we evaluated the role of silicone stents in these patients, and we found that in primary DCRs, you know, intubating is not going to give you much help, so you can just leave the stents alone for re-DCRs. I'll just skip these slides. Then the, you know, what I was talking about was enlarging with the instruments. So see, this is the Blakesley's forceps, a very useful tube. This is a sickle knife. You must keep this with you, and it'll immensely help you in enlarging the ostium. Now, what these are the complications which have been described in the literature, but what I had initially was a hemorrhage. If you keep touching the endoscope with, you know, it's not properly held, and if you keep traumatizing the nasal mucosa, and you will have bleeding in between, and that is the most important thing. Learn your endoscopy properly. The other thing is, never fire the laser when it is not hitting the bone. If you fire the laser in the air anywhere, it's going to damage your canaliculus and lead to proximal blocks. That's the most important thing. Then one very bad experience we had was the laser probe got damaged, and see this, what has happened, this is a, we published this, this is a nasocutaneous fistula which developed, it was a nightmare. We had to dress it for, you know, weeks together, and eventually, thank God, this ostium closed. It was like, you know, gutter which we had created with the laser. So be very careful while you're using these, you know, laser probes. And finally, I had to go in and do a conjunctival DCR for this patient. So what a mess it was created. So contraindications in the literature, nasal septal deviation has been, you know, written, and these are the other ones. I used to send my all my patients for ENT examination, and you used to write DNS in all patients, and you know, he said no, these are fit for ENT surgery. I stopped sending patients and started doing it myself, and this is another paper we have published, and we found that you know, if you want to do transcanalicular DCR, you can do it in the low basal DNS and the middle DNS, but don't do it in high DNS where your endoscopy becomes very difficult. You can actually use a lens spatula to retract the terminate. It's basically at the root of the terminate that you want to visualize. So just use a lens spatula to retract this terminate, and you can visualize. If you can visualize where you want to make an opening, you can get away. If you cannot visualize, please don't do it. Leave it for the ENT person. So this is, I presented it in the British Oculoplastia Society, and now it is published in International Ophthalmology. And this is the success rate we had, 94.4%. And 9 months, you can see, you can hardly see the opening, but if you just retract it with an instrument, you can see the probe which is coming out. So you can see this probe which is coming out. So this is at the end of 1 year, the success rate which we had. And to conclude, I'm really running fast. Silicone into patient did not increase the success rate in our series of cases. And we believe that laser DCR with, of course, augmentation, the way I do, is effective procedure in mild and moderate DCRs. I mean to say, if it's a severe DNS, if it's a severe DNS, the, you know, the turbinate is going to touch the septum, and anyway, you can't put the endoscope. And I use this procedure for bilateral DCRs and also for acute DCRs, acute dacryocystitis. And key is create a very large osteotomy. Large means at least 8 millimeter, and place it at the bottom part of the lacrimal sac, and avoid nasal mucosal damage by gentle retraction. Bottom part is again important, because again we have reported a sump syndrome which has occurred even in conjunctival laser DCR, because the, you know, the opening was not properly made. So thank you so much, and I hope I have motivated you to learn it.
Thank you. Now we'll have